Hey guys, Maturka here. Welcome to another tutorial. I'm so excited. I have a lot to say before we get started, and hopefully I can squeeze everything in. This is the bag that we are going to be making today. It is so cute, isn't it? Here are the details. Here's the studs on the bottom, and then we have a regular old chain with loops and everything. I am going to take you step by step to making this video. First thing, I got everything at the same place, which was Joann. So if you want to know where I bought the stuff, Joann Fabric. Second thing, I would classify this as intermediate to advanced. So if you are a beginner, a lot of the tools and materials you might not have. Second, third or fourth or whatever. If this is your first video you've seen of my tutorial, please don't subscribe to me, and I only say that in my sewing tutorials because I don't do the sewing tutorials or DIYs very often on my channel, and I don't want you to think that my channel is based on DIYs and sewing thingy-wingies. Sewing tutorials, which it's not. So, yeah, my channel probably won't be very entertaining for you. Alright, so this video, I'm just going to say out hand, this is intermediate to advanced. Some of these tools you're going to need for this video. Some of these tools you're not going to. But I just want to mention all of them because maybe it will be helpful for those who might not have everything that I have on this paper. Alright, first thing I want to mention is the scissors. You can use regular fabric scissors. I'm just using these particular scissors because I like them. They're more heavy duty. I like the back end of them because I use them to bend my hardware so I can save my fingertips, because when you sew for a long period of time and you keep using your fingertips for everything, you will have raw fingertips, people. Raw. So, I like to use other things to bend simple, easy things like studs and other things with, okay? Pliers, of course, you can use pliers. Pliers are always needed when you're dealing with hardware for a purse. Other things you're going to need, seam rippers. You always need seam rippers because if you make a mistake, you need to cut and replace or fix a seam or fix a line on the purse that you don't like. You're going to need seam rippers. I have three different kinds, the traditional regular seam ripper with the little red tip on it. We have a little tiny scissors here. And then we have the more heavy duty seam ripper. I really like these. These are really good quality, and I've had these for a while now. Of course, you're going to need your markers for leaving your marks onto the fabric. You can use a pen. I'm going to be probably using a Sharpie today because I'm really not that picky. Most of the time, you're not going to be able to see the marks that I make on the fabric anyway, so I don't go out and buy the little chalky thing that most people do. Other thing, we are going to be doing hand sewing. Since we're going to be doing hand sewing, which is required for this purse, it would be very difficult to try to do it with your sewing machine. Not saying that I haven't done it before. I have. But for the quality that you need the purse to look like, it's going to be so much easier to do by hand. All right, so you're going to need your heavy-duty thread. You're not going to use your regular traditional heavy-duty thread. You're going to need your outdoor thread, which is thicker in diameter, and so you're going to need really strong thread to hold the purse together. And the needle that we're going to be using is our leather needle. I really like leather needles. They're really sharp on the tip. It's in a different shape than the traditional hand needle. And the hand needle is in a more of a round shape. This one is in a triangle shape. And it just glides through the fabric a lot better, and the leather a lot better, so that you can hand sew whatever you need to hand sew. When you're hand sewing, of course, you're going to need a really good thimble. I'm using this one today, or in the tutorial. I might go back and forth and use both of these. It just depends. I really like this because it has little indentions in the metal piece that's protecting your finger so that when you put your needle against it, it won't slide up and down or around it. It will stay right in one of the indentions that are placed in the metal. This one here is really, really nice. The only thing is the backing comes off after using it for some time, so you might want to glue it back on to make sure it stays in place. But it has a little plastic or metal piece right in here that protects your tip, so it's not just leather. It also has a metal piece right in this part right here. Of course, if you're intermediate level and you don't have all of these thimbles, you could also use the traditional metal one. The only thing that I would recommend is that you shape it to your finger. If you can see, this is actually very oval shape, and when it's more oval shape, you can actually keep it on your finger. If you keep it in the round shape, it won't stay in your finger. So of course you want to pinch it onto your finger, not too tightly, but tight enough so that it will stay in place. I'm going to be using a Brother XR40. The reason why is because it's cheap and it's easily come by. You can get it at Walmart. You can get it at a lot of different places. And I've been using it for years and I've had no problems with the Brothers. All right. The foots you're going to be needing are, of course, your zipper foot and your zigzag foot. The thread I'm going to be using is just a nylon thread that's black and shiny. I really like that thread. This is just a regular cream zipper, which is, I recommend probably like a 12 inch zipper, regular chain, black. My theme is kind of like a goth, so all of my hardware is going to be a darker metallic. This is going on the bottom of my purse. This is just for accents. This is the button. This is the magnet. If you can tell, everything is sticks to it pretty much because it's a magnet. Then of course we have our loops for our chain to hold up our purse. Alright, so I think that's everything. Alright, so let's go ahead and get into the cutting of the material. Okay, so I have cut out all the pieces that I need for my project. Sorry, it's kind of looking a little bit crazy here, but we have the two front pieces, and because the fur lays down this way, I actually put it this way so that it will get all nice and rough and not symmetrical and perfect looking, so I'm going to be sewing it on this way. Of course, you need the matching inside pieces of the lining for the purse. And then I've labeled each piece that I have. So this is labeled bottom. So this is the bottom of it right here. And then we have the two sides. And I like to cut all the pieces that I need out for the purse to make things a lot more easier for me. And I will label the pieces the particular name so that I can keep up with it. All right, and then of course the pieces have its own matching lining in the interior. Now for the sides of the purse, I actually have the base of the purse, which is this part right in here. That's the base of the purse. The side part right here, which is this, the lining is going to include the inches of the base part. So the lining is going to be just a few half an inch longer than the actual purse. So when you sew this part, which is the two pieces of the base together with the purse, it will include the extension inside of the purse, the length of the purse. So that's just one trick that You have to remember when you're doing the lining for the inside of the purse that the side will be actually longer than the outside leather piece, because the outside leather piece has the bottom base, which you sew to the center part of the purse. All right. Now you will notice that this is stiffening fabric stiffener, and it is the iron-on kind. I'm going to be ironing on this piece to the base of the purse and to the leather side of the purse as well. And if you notice here, this as well has the extension, because I am going to be ironing this on to the base of the purse so that the purse will stand up a little bit more firm. And over here are the front flaps. I have labeled them out so that I know what parts are what, and I will be showing you how to do that as well. Now, once you've sewn the flap on, you are going to also need fabric glue, and you're going to cut out the piece to match the actual sewn on part. So once you've sewn the flap all together, then we're going to have the matching fabric piece to go along with that to help hide the inside of this. But I will show you each part. I just wanted to show you guys that you're going to need to cut out every piece that you need before you start the project, just so that it will make the sewing of the purse go a lot faster, a lot smoother. All right, so the first thing that we're going to be sewing today at this moment is going to be the bottom of the purse. All I'm doing is literally sewing around in a circle, and as I sew on the additional piece, I take my seam ripper here and I will take the edge off of the seam, just this part here. I'm just taking the corner out. And the reason why I do that is to give me enough space to sew on the next piece evenly and flat. So that's what you want to do. Show you as best as I can. I started all the way from the edge here, which is in that corner, and I sewed all the way to the point here. And this is what closes up the corner of the edges that you took out with the seam ripper. Okay, so now we've sewn all four corners, and you can flip it inside out. The next step is we're going to be sewing this flap downward, down like that. The straighter your lines, the better the purse looks. Okay, and if you can see that, I have my lines holding the bottom of my bag. Alright, so we are going to actually sew the mid part of the purse together and the bottom part of the purse. I just wanted to show you this so you can know exactly what happened. Okay, so I sewed on the bottom part just like so. So it's going to create kind of like a dome effect. Now I'm going to flip it inside out. Alright, the next step that we're going to do is we're going to put a line all the way around the base of the purse. So there's going to be a black line that's going to go all the way around the bottom of this part to really fuse these pieces together. Alright, so now I'm just showing you real quick the lining of the bag. I did that at the same time when I sewed on the bottom of the bag. Everything matches up perfectly. Now we're going to do the part for the zipper. Now this part of the zipper is just the front flap. And I wouldn't say it's a front flap, it's just a front part of the zipper. Now this is the actual flap that has all of the hardware on it with the skull and the studs. I'm sewing all of the pieces together. And if you can see there, I'm just sewing all the pieces together. And now I'm going to turn it inside out. And once I turn it inside out, I'm going to be doing some lines on it, just some straight black lines. And it just helps out with keeping the flap really flat.
And it's just provides some kind of aesthetic look to it as well. Now, once you do that, now it's time to fold, to sew on the back flap. And so, of course, you're going to pin it down. And I specifically really want to pin this part down is because you want to make sure that that back flap is placed on there just perfectly. And if you can pay attention, that I have it so that when you flip it over the zipper, the front half is what is exposed. Because you don't want to sew it on backwards. And right here I'm just showing you basically all the hardware and how I'm putting it on. And again, you don't have to use your hands. You can use your scissors or other pliers or whatever you want to use to save your fingertips. And now we're going to be using the iron-on fabric stiffener. Now, you don't have to use iron-on fabric stiffener. You can use plastic. You can use a lot of different type of materials to stiffen up your purse. I just use fabric stiffener because it's easy to get at your local fabric store and it's not hard to find. So I just prefer to use this and it works perfectly fine. What I actually do is I make sure that the measurements for this part is perfect. I sew it on, and then once I sew it on, I iron it on. And this just makes it so that it's extremely firm, and it just depends on how many layers you're doing. One purse, I use two of the iron-on fabric, and then another purse, I just used one. It just really depends. And once I've sewn all those parts on, the next step is we're going to put the D loop in so that we can provide the chain for the purse. And if you can see, I simply sewed the zipper onto the two outer flaps once I was finished with everything. And the zipper is very easy. You can go online and look up how to sew a simple zipper onto any kind of project. And I am doing the D loop part by hand. Easier for me to do it by hand. I can be really, really picky with it and be really focused on where things go. Where you can also do this with a sewing machine, but since it's right there next to the hardware, if you're not really used to sewing zippers and hardware into fabric, you might accidentally hit your needle against the metal, and I don't want you to mess your sewing machine up.
Now we're to the part where you want to iron on what you've sewn on. For this particular purse, I am going to actually use two layers. You don't have to use two layers, you can use one layer. It just depends on how stiff you want your purse. But for this one,